Today's topic, the dual clutch transmission, components, function, and power curve. This video is about the basic structure, components, and power curve in a dual clutch transmission. I will explain this using the example of the 6-speed dual clutch transmission launched by the Volkswagen Group in 2003. It was the first dual clutch transmission to be used in large-scale production. Today, there are different versions of dual clutch transmissions. However, the basic principle always remains the same. The transmission, known as O2E, consists of the following main components and assemblies, which I will discuss in more detail in the video. The dual clutch, subtransmission 1, and subtransmission 2. The reverse shaft for reverse gear. The mechatronics. And the oil supply, consisting of the oil pump, oil cooler, and oil filter. This transmission features a wet clutch. The clutch plates run in an oil bath. The dual clutch housing is connected via gear teeth to the dual mass flywheel, which is connected to the engine crankshaft and always rotates at engine speed. The engine speed is transmitted to the clutch housing and thus to the main hub via the gearing. The outer disc carriers of clutch 1 and clutch 2 are located on the main hub, which means that they also always rotate at engine speed. Let's start with clutch 1. This is for the odd gears, i.e. first, third, and fifth gear, as well as reverse gear. It is the outer and therefore larger clutch, as the highest torque is transmitted in first gear. As already explained, the torque is transmitted to the outer disc carrier. When clutch C1 closes, with oil pressure being controlled by the mechatronics in the oil pressure chamber C1, the torque is transferred from the outer disc carrier to the inner disc carrier via the outer and inner discs. This is connected to the drive shaft 1 via a gearing, which therefore also rotates at engine speed. In this design, clutch 1 has a disc spring that opens the clutch as soon as there is no longer any oil pressure in the oil pressure chamber 1. Here you can see an original clutch from a dual clutch transmission, the housing with cover and the gearing that connects to the dual mass flywheel. There is usually a retaining ring on the cover, which I have already removed. Once the cover has been removed, the outer disc carrier of clutch 1 can be seen. This houses the outer discs of clutch 1. The inner disc carrier of clutch 1 can also be seen, with the teeth that connect it to drive shaft 1. After removing the first outer disc, you can see an inner disc sitting on the inner disc carrier. The image shows clutch 2. It is responsible for power transmission to subtransmission 2, and thus for the straight gears, i.e. second, fourth, and sixth gears. Here too, the torque is transmitted to the outer plate carrier of clutch 2. When clutch C2 closes by the piston C2 being actuated by the oil pressure in the oil pressure chamber C2, the power is transferred from the outer disc carrier via the outer and inner discs to the inner disc carrier and via the teeth to drive shaft 2, which is designed as a hollow shaft. Drive shaft 2 rotates at engine speed. A coil spring is used to open clutch 2. After removing the inner disc carrier from clutch 1, the following parts of clutch 2 are visible. The outer disc carrier, the outer discs, slightly concealing the inner discs and the inner disc carrier. In the center is the gearing that connects to drive shaft 2. Let us now turn to the function in the two subtransmissions. Let us begin with subtransmission 1. Drive shaft 1, colored blue in the image, is connected to the integral gears of first, third, fifth, and reverse gears. When drive shaft 1, which is connected to the engine by clutch 1, rotates, these so-called integrated gears also rotate. In subtransmission 1, there is also a pulse generator wheel on drive shaft 1. This has a sensor that communicates the speed of drive shaft 1 to the mechatronic control unit. In subtransmission 2, drive shaft 2 is designed as a hollow shaft. When drive shaft 2 rotates, the integrated gear of the second gear and the integrated gears of the fourth and sixth gears also rotate. Here too, there is a pulse generator wheel to communicate the speed of drive shaft 2 to the mechatronic control unit. Let's now take a look at the gear shifting processes. The transmission has two output shafts. Let's start with output shaft 1. Output shaft 1 houses the gear wheels for first, third, fourth, and second gear, as well as the output gear, which connects to the differential. Output shaft 1 also has the sliding sleeves for gears 1 and 3, as well as 2 and 4. If the mechatronics move sliding sleeve 1 through 3 to the left, gear 1 is connected to the output shaft via the synchronizer. When clutch 1 closes, power is transmitted from the engine via clutch 1, driveshaft 1, integrated gear 1, and gear wheel 1 to driveshaft 1, and thus from the output gear to the differential. First gear is engaged. The big advantage of the dual clutch transmission is the extremely fast gear change in only about 40 milliseconds. How does this work? If the vehicle continues to accelerate in first gear, second gear is pre-selected. To do this, the sliding sleeve 2-4 is pushed to the right. This means that the gear wheel of the second gear is firmly connected to the output shaft 1 via the synchronizer. Now clutch 1 is opened and clutch 2 is closed at the same time. The power is now transferred from the engine via clutch 2, driveshaft 2, second gear integrated wheel, second gear wheel via output shaft 1 to the differential. Second gear is engaged. The vehicle continues to accelerate. The mechatronic system therefore pre-selects third gear. To do this, sliding sleeve 1-3 is pushed to the right. This connects the third gear wheel to output shaft 1 via the synchronizer. Clutch 2 opens. Clutch 1 closes. Power is now transmitted from the engine via clutch 1, driveshaft 1, third gear integrated wheel, third gear wheel, driveshaft 1, to the output gear and thus to the differential. Third gear is engaged. This principle also applies to fourth gear. Fourth gear is pre-selected. Sliding sleeve 2-4 moves to the left. Clutch 1 opens. Clutch 2 closes. The power curve is shown by the red line. In this image, output shaft 2 has been added. Output shaft 2 carries the gear wheels for 5th, 6th, and reverse gears. It also carries the sliding sleeve for 5th gear and the sliding sleeve for 6th gear and reverse gear. There is another output gear on output shaft 2, which is connected to the ring gear of the differential. A pulse generator wheel is installed to detect the transmission output speed. Reverse gear will be discussed in more detail later in the video. The same principle applies to output shaft 2 as to the output shaft. When accelerating, the next higher gear is pre-selected. Let's take the change from 5th to 6th gear as an example. Clutch 1 is closed. 5th gear is engaged. 6th gear is pre-selected by the mechatronics. Clutch 1 opens. Clutch 2 closes. 6th gear is engaged. The system works in the same way when downshifting. The power curve for 5th gear is shown in yellow. The power curve for 6th gear is shown in green. Let us now turn our attention to reverse gear. For clarity, all previous images have been drawn in an elongated form. The reverse shaft can now be seen. The image on the right shows the actual position of the various shafts and the ring gear of the differential. This means that, contrary to what appears in the image on the left, the intermediate gear for reverse gear is not suspended in the air, but is connected to the fixed gear for first gear and reverse gear of driveshaft 1. To engage reverse gear, the sliding sleeve 6, reverse gear is moved to the right. The clutch 1 closes. The power of the engine is transmitted via clutch 1, driveshaft 1, integrated wheel 1. Reverse gear, intermediate wheel 1 reverse gear, reverse shaft, intermediate wheel 2 reverse gear. To the reverse gear engaged via the synchronizer to output shaft 2 and thus to the ring gear of the differential. Reverse gear is engaged. Thanks for watching. More videos on my channel. Like and subscribe. Thanks.